Hanflo Somali Community's third anniversary. My name is Waris Duale, and I will be your host for the night, along with my lovely co-host, Mohammed Saeed Al-Sahab. We've got a lot in store for you guys tonight. We've got some performances, we've got speeches, and also a few awards that we're going to give out tonight. Let's give a round of applause to our first speaker of the night, who will be talking to us about the journey of HSC. Fadhia.
Good evening and welcome. May I take this opportunity to welcome you all and to extend a further word of welcome to everyone here this evening. The third anniversary of Hanflo Somali Community is certainly a moment that we should all savour and enjoy. If you take a chance or to take a quick look around you, I'm sure you will all agree that our community has come a long way in the past years. It all started as a dream. Samar Tadala, Salma Hassan and I envisioned the dream of giving something back to the community by getting involved in helping to build a better community for our children, as they are all of our futures. We also hope to guide future generations of enlightened minds. We have had many wonderful events in the past, as you may all know and remember. We would like to take you through a journey of our highlights throughout the last 3 years. We'd love it if you could share this beautiful night with us. We'd like to extend our gratitude and thanks to all the role players that have made it possible for our dreams to come true. You are all very most welcome to stay and enjoy this evening. I personally hope you enjoy the evening's programme and would like to thank you all for sharing this special event with us. Thank you.
Waxaan jeclahay bal markaanna inaan u yeero mid ka mid ah fanaaniinta Soomaalida. Shakhsiyan anigu aan taageero Hanflo Somali Community-na in badan oo aan imid wax u qabatay ah mar hooyo marna ah saaxiib wanaagsan.
I'm gonna go get some more. Muhammad Food. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Shamsa. Thank you. Right, we always recognize community contribution. Could I please put your hands together and warm welcome to Councillor Jagdish Sharma to award Shamsa Muhammad Food. For her dedications and contribution, she did that song in her own time and contributed her own money and her own beliefs. And that's why we're here tonight. Because of her, we are thriving. We are, and we will get to the situation and the position that we will get to in about 2 years' time, and that is to have a community development center. And you are all part in it. You all contribute, and we will succeed together.
It is a real pleasure for me to be here on the kind invitation of from your Somali Community Association, and I am lucky in one way that I attended the other 2 years when you had these annual functions. So you can see, so far I am coming here regularly, and it's 100% attendance. I am very pleased the way you are supporting your association and the good work your association is doing. It's marvelous to see, because I've been in the last 2 years when we had this function at Hounslow Manor School, and particularly I'm also very pleased with your youngsters. I was reading your magazine, The Progress, and the children are coming in generations are making, and I will be very proud to see that they will be the excellent citizen of this borough and contribute a lot. That's what we wish, and that's what I can see that you will be able to do. And you can see the now wonderful songs. And thank you very much. I think I would like to, you would like to be very brief also. So I want to thank you once again.
Thank you. Would you mind doing the honor for us? Thank you.
I am in a real Hanslow girl now. I'm very proud to be a Somalian, especially be standing beside for all my fellow Somalian and also all my fellows British, UK. I'm proud to be here and thank you. And I don't know how to thank for the work you've done. And what I'm saying is carry on, show must go on, and thank you very much.
Okay, next up we've got the volunteers of HSC who have each prepared a speech followed by Samata, who will be talking about the House of Somali Communities six-month campaign.
Assalamu alaikum, and once again, welcome to HSC's third year anniversary. My name is Yasmin Solomon, and at the moment, I am studying science, and I would like to become a radiographer in the near future. I have been with HSC for a little under a year, and I have been able to gain new learning experiences and new curves from my time at HSC. In this, I'd like to inform you about our initial project, which was foster caring amongst different communities. Are you able to raise a child that is not your own? Within the first initial meeting, we were able to discuss the negatives and positives of raising a child that is not your own skin color, not your own religion either. We were also able to gain an insight on how it is living with a child that is not your own amongst children that you have given birth to yourself, and how what hardships you will overcome.
The most important reason or the factor that contributed for us to arranging such documentary, such events for the Somali community and the Muslim community. There was a large number of Somalis being taken into care, and there was not even one Somali foster carer or Somali adoptive parent available or registered with the local authority within West London. There was issues with Hammersmith Council, there was issues with Ealing, as well as Barnet. So we had to do something as a grassroots organization. Our children are our future. Therefore, we had to raise awareness to all of you. And during the event, the majority who attended said, I only want to look after Somali children. We've tackled that and we've challenged you, right? Every child matters. Just because you're a Somali parent doesn't mean that you have to look after a Somali child. So with you know, a great partnership working with the fostering department within Hanslow Council, we were able to agree with the Somali parent to look after Muslim children. So you didn't limit yourself, but you were able to open the doors for any other child who matters to us. So thank you very much for those who took part in it. There was 35 people who registered. Unfortunately, only two fulfilled the fostering criteria. And I am so proud for those two parents who are now in the register, available to look after Muslim children. Thank you. Shall I now bring Manfa, who, that's his nickname. His name is Mohammed Ismail Aka Manfa. He will now present you the second HSC event, which is all about the welfare reform and reform updates and information session. Give it up for Manfa.
My name is Mohammed Ismail, also known as Manfa. A bit about myself. I go to Twickenham Academy. I study A-level. Subjects I study is maths, IT and business. Apart from that, I do enrichment programs which boost my physical, mental and verbal activities. Samata has been an inspirational person. I met him during the Ramadan of 2012, and since then he has intrigued me with his ambitious vision and motivational words. We had a lot of things in common, football, fundraising, social events. I'm also a youth champion, which is a title awarded amongst the youth. That's enough about me. Let me move on to the event I'm presenting. The purpose of the Wellform Reform event was to update the community, working in partnership with Hansel Council, Job Centre Plus, and Somali professionals. HSC delivered 4-point information sessions to the community in order to find out more about the changes to welfare and benefits. We have informed the community how the changes will affect them and how to find out about job opportunities. Thank you very much.
And applause to another young presenter. Her name is Samira Abdi.
I currently study business at West End College. I joined HSC recently. And I've experienced a lot of things here. I'm glad that I was volunteering to help this event tonight, and inshallah many more to come. Hands of Somali Community in partnership with Kingsley Academy hosted Aspire to Inspire, our first annual Somali Community Achievement Awards in Hansel. On the 23rd of May 2013, HSC hosted the hugely successful Historic Somali Achievement Awards evening. Hands of Somali students from Kingsley Academy were presented with a special award to outstanding achievement in a number of categories, including special attendance, sports personality of the year, student leadership, most academically improved, best results in GCSEs, and the students of the year awards. Special awards were also presented to Mohamed Deria, a Somali marathon runner who lives in Hounslow, who has been inspired by a double Olympic gold medalist, legendary Renvar.
We are still through the young person's presentation. Please give it up for Mr. Elmi, who will now present the fourth event. Thank you.
I'm living in Bristol, and I've also got a scholarship there for playing basketball. So that's a bit about me and what I do. Going on to the event bit, we've organised some tournaments for all the kids around Hounslow to play and to take part in. Around 40 kids took part in this event, and they played each other back to back, and also there was also a prize for the winning team.
Way hay bal markaana waa qaybtan sugayay ee ah qaybta riwaayada aan jecelnahay riwaayada magaceeda waxa la yiraahdaa oo aan dawadayaasha iyo gudahan aan ilaahay dadkeena laga jooga aan jecelnahay fadlan inay soo dhaweeyaan waa riwaayadii dhaqan iyo dhoof waa riwaayadii dhaqan iyo dhoof
Wait, let's see your names. بروح على إنجلترا يوم ماشي واحد اللي حق إنجلترا عايز ما أقول إنجلترا دي قارس ترى وأنا إنجلترا بيت إنجلترا يوم وسكرين كانوا قارس يا أبو حسن أنا سوى عالي لكن أظن بريني روح تصور عشان ده أنا حسوا 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 في الجمعة
ما أنا الله حافظ ما دام دام سبعة
وكافريكي أنا يمكن يجيك ناس والله يوم وانسكت على مالنا بريني روح حي
وساكننا فان حوداي
السلام عليكم
عليكم السلام
Hello, Mr. Trump.
How are you doing, my friend?
You're looking so nice. I like this high standard. Very swaggy. I like this. Mr. Trump, we have a little problem. And you know, hot Altima, guys, I don't know my. You know the problem. And I have my friend, his name is Abdallah. And do the Donian or Dolph? You know Dolph? No, Gallo, do you know the plane air? And the airplane blew.
So someone's trapped?
Yes.
Okay.
He wanted to go to England.
England.
Well, do you know that England? That's where I want to go. England, what's England? I know England.
Okay, so who's his fellow?
And his name is Abdallah Chan Amalubi. We have called him Abdallah.
Alright, Abdallah.
And he wanted to know how much the price roughly.
$5,000.
Who?
Do I have to tell him? Allah taala power dad buu isiree Allah buu weeyaan isla fulay Allah amla ma qol ma ha
wala
in galan baa
joogna
hadii go jidoo ma 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 hanqulay qabqabow yes fufuu no
no
qabqabow
yes
qabqabow
no
ma asluxa isu waye isu no
hadda
baan ku soo naxanay waay isu isu iyo waxa tan jiraa sooma soo wada garo qoray yaa waxa saxay la qoray waxa ma waqiyaare waxa saxay la qoray hadii ay ka dhabtahay tuma waxa ku probeeyay hadii ka dhabtahay marka waxa doon qoro ilaa waxa jira ajidii oo aan jira aw tan la sii oo intaas oo dhan oo sidoo su'aal tahay isu lagaane furmaayo tan qoray ajidii saadiya oo jira oo aan jira oo aan tan la sii oo xalkay ku taala arooshii ku taala wali ku furmaayo ay soo doonta taasan u dibaya tan tan markay tabad u jeexay dhufay waxa hadii ay jeexay oo ka dhacaysa hadii kale
hay ma xartay waxa
waxa uu soo wadaa maay
ha waxa uu soo
yaa
isii waxa
uu soo wadaa ha waxa uu
Allah ma hay fureysa wala ma kuu soo wadaa yaraye
yaa
ma hay fureysa
waxa uu ka soo wadaa
hadii hadii meeri ka soo wadaa
ha ma xaq waxa uu
soo wadaa waxa uu soo wadaa
abu yoo intaale oo aan ku dhin taagan tahay ee waxa dambo
يقول انا حاسس ان حاجه غلط ديفورس تاس صبر يا بيه هو مش صح
ديفورس
بيبي ديفورس
وديني وديني
وديني واحد من الصوت
ها
قدم يا مخرك يا مخرك
waxaan u yeerayaa oo gudoonsiinaya qaybta ugu horeysa hooyo ka mid a hooyooyinka soomaalida dadka runaxaantii aynu si fiican u garanayno shaqada ay qabato ka timid xaafadda Hays ee deegaanka Harlington ee galbeedka London. Fadlan waxaad ila soo dhaweysiin Mama Canab oo gudoonsiin doonta abaalmarinada sacabkuna waa xaggiin waayahay samatar wuxuu na siin doonaa haddii ay beedmo abaalmarinada dadka aynu ugu talagalna waxaana gudoonsiin doonaa hooyo Canab. Qofka ugu horeeya ee aynu gudoonsiin doonno magaceeda waxaa la yidhaahdaa Salma. waayahay Maama Canab qofka labaad ay siin doonto haddii ay beedmo abaalmarinta waa Fatxiya Nageeye. Fatxiya Nageeye, fadlan sacabku waa xaggiina. Fatxiya Nageeye, waxaa inaga maqan Waris oo ah qofka saddexaad ee abaalmarinta heli lahaa oo barnaamijka ila furtay markaynu bilaabaynay. maadaama Waris ay meel ku degdegsaneed, waxaa u qaadi doona Fatxiya oo ay isla shaqeeyaan. waxaan jecelnahay fursad inaanu siino maadaama Maama Canab ay tahay qof runaxaantii wax badan qabatay hal iyo labo inay soo koobto, waxayna nooga timid ilaa xaafadda Hays.
waxaan aad iyo aad marka hore ugu mahadnaqayaa Samatar iyo organizationkiisa iyo volunteerskiisa, really aad iyo aad iyo aad bay u mahadsan yihiin. waa markii labaad ama markii saddexaad ee aan ka soo qayb galay ahaan isloo shaqada uu Samatar qabtay. waxaan xagga Hays aan rabaa inaan yar idinka yara taabto organizationkaas sidaa uu Samatar u bilaabay baan u bilownay. وقت جابن لكن هو إن كسيد النوع كله حاجة حافظنا لدقنا تريني فر بدن نسينا كله إذا ما ترنا ونقدر ندورنا إن شاء الله تعالى يجروب كيسو وحنو ما نتجرنينا نودسنا كريتشنسي أي أش قيسه هو يسومالي تذكرنا أش قيودن ووضع سومالي ويا وانا ندورنا إنا نوش قينو all موسم كوا حنو مرينا إلا بقول هو يو كسو قاضي شابسن تركي professionals وديهين شقيستا benefits kaab ku aanu taabanin kuna jira maaragtay bixinayna national insurance bixinaya tax key bixinaya oo shaqeysanaya idinkana inta halkan joogta insha Allah waxaan idinka rajaynayna taas oo kale ina samaysan intaas oo hooyintii aan shaqeynayna ay shaqeyso wax ku soo kordhiyaan dalka waa step key ugu horeeyay sabatar insha Allah taala well congratulations dhammaan tiimka thank you
waxaan jecelahay inaad si wanaagsan ila soo dhaweeyaan Councillor Ruth Cadbury, if you can come and join us.
What a fantastic evening. And I absolutely want to congratulate everyone who's been involved in the journey over the last 3 years. It's a wonderful achievement that the community has come together and done so much together. And I think I've been there almost since the beginning, and I've been to several events and I've seen many of you there. I am so in awe of everything you've achieved and with no funding as well, which is fantastic. So huge congratulations to everyone who's been involved in that, particularly the management committee and all your volunteers who lead the sessions and you spend your own time doing that. And the breadth of work that you do is just fantastic. Under this government, the Somali community more than any other has been hit by the welfare benefit changes. So the work you've done in the workshops, giving people advice and information about how to deal with the bedroom tax and the cutbacks in benefits, how to get jobs, where to learn English, etc., etc. So important in such difficult times. And I know the Somali community also very badly hit by the shortage of decent quality affordable housing. I don't know how some of you mums survive in small flats and houses with large numbers of children. I am in awe, and we do our best to provide enough adequate housing, but it is a trouble. It is a struggle. We are trying, and 3,000 overcrowded. Councillor Sampson is going to say more about this. And Councillor Sue Sampson, who's been so amazing with all the work she's done supporting and helping Somali families. So, big round of applause. Yeah. She's on in a minute. And everything, and you supported family work, but also children's work, integration, sport, self-esteem, all really, really important. And the Somali community is really coming into its own. I am so proud of the achievements of Somali youngsters in our schools, going to university. A young man in my ward in Brentford, a young man in my ward in Brentford grew up with his family in Brentford. He graduated from Oxford. He now works in the city. It's just fantastic.
We're going to be presenting an award, and Councillor Pruth will be presenting this award to a man who worked hard for this community here in Hounslow and across the country in the UK, and former UK Chairman Somali Community, Fadlan Saabku Hagina. Please welcome Abdi Omar. Fadlan Saabku Wahagin. Abdi waxaan jecelnahay daqiiqadeena nusino si uu marka dareenkiisa uga hadlo.
Runtii waxaan aad iyo aad I'm very excited. Very, very excited. And I'm shaking in my heart, really, because of waxay ahayday warka aad ujeedaan caawo dad badan oo iga mudan aan fadhiyo oo dumarka Soomaaliyeed u badan oo aan la qiyaasi karin shaqada ay qabteen. Runtii aan ku ammaanayo Hanslow Somali community into shaqadan la waday habeen iyo maalin dadka taagna oo u taagna waxay ahaayeen dumar ka Soomaaliyeed waxaan runtii rabaa inaan si fiican ugu mahadceliyo soo koobayo samatar iyo dhalinyaradii yararka ah ee la shaqeynaysey oo runtii u istaagay oo dhaxda u xirtay iyagoo arkay in community-goodu especially dhalinyarada Soomaaliyeed inay dhibaateysan tahay una istaagay habeen iyo maalinna u taagnaa saddex sano kadibna meesha maanta ay joogna soo gaarsiin hanisla Soomaali community intaa kadib waxaan rabaa inaan ku soo gabagabeeyo hadalkayga sheeko yar oo jooga nin ayaa wuxuu ahaa nin aad u shaqo badan uu shaqeyn jiray uu shaqeeyay lacag aad u tiro badan uu shaqeeyay lacagtiisa meelna kuma bixin jirin akoonka ugu jirjirta ninkii baa maalintaba xaaskiisa u yeeray wuxuu ku yiri xaaskayga qaaliga ahayday haddii aan dhinto lacagtan qabriga igula aas waxaan u shaqeystay markaan dhinto kadib inaan ku manaafacaade way haytir ballantii waa ka gudoontay waxay ballan qaaday haddii uu dhinto lacagtaas inay la aasi doonto qabriga kula duugi doonto ninkii odaga ahaa waa geeriyooday markuu geeriyooday islaantii waa fikirtay waxay ku fikirtay sida lacagta ay ku qaadan lahayd ballantiina ay ku fulin lahayd waxay garatay inay qorto jeek oo jeegaas ay kula xarayso qabriga lacagta rayada qaad marka taas waxaan ula jeedaa hakaha karnaha dhaqaalihiina hanislow Somali community oo runtii idin hayo shaqo fiican dhalinyarada yararka habeen iyo maalin taagan waxay ballan qaadeen inay dhisayaan meel ay leedahay hanislow Somali community oo dhan oo lagu fulin doono shaqooyinka hanislow Somali community oo la yiraahdo hanislow Somali community center waxay taasi u baahan tahay marka dhaqaalihiina oo la garab istaagtaan insha Allah wixii ay hayaan oo dhaqaalaha iyaga idin sheegi doona conclusionka laakiin wax badan waa la qabtay wax badanna waa dhiman yihiin jeebkiina loo baahan yahay intaas aan ku soo gabagabeynayaa hadalkayga aad iyo aad ayaad u mahadsantihiin thank you very much aad u mahadsantahay samatar aad baad u mahadsantahay shaqada aad qabatayna aad baan kugu mahadcelinayaa thank you very much thank you saaf kala mahadsantahay
waxa markaan aan u yeeray Councillor Sue Sampson please welcome
I want to congratulate the Hounslow Somali community for coming this far. It's not been an easy ride, especially with no funding, as Ruth rightfully said, you know, but they've achieved what they have, and you, the people, have made that, helped them make that a success. And you need to reflect on that also, because if you can do this, you're capable of doing a lot more. All right, now we have, since winning the election in May, my cabinet portfolio was changed. I've now have the portfolio for communities, economic development and domestic violence. Now, I want to talk a little bit about the economic development side of things because there's opportunities there with it for our young people between the ages of 16 to 24 to take up apprenticeships. Not only is facilitated by the council, but it's not only it's not positions solely within the council, but it could be with Sky Television and various organisations. Now, if that's something you are interested in your young people, or if you know a young person that is prepared to, that wants to take that route, please let him contact Samatar initially, and then we can take that forward, okay? Now, also, there's another opportunity around you. Now, Ruth touched upon it within her speech regarding the election in May this year, regarding the parliamentary elections. Now, people think, oh, well, what's politics? You know, I'm not interested in politics. What's politics got to do with me? Politics is everyday life. Politics affects each and every one of you in this room. Now, I have been fortunate to represent this community for the last 5 years now. Now, I've stood on this stage at a number of events asking for women to come forward and join the Labour Party and help each other. Because we all start somewhere. I started somewhere, Ruth started somewhere. Everybody, so long as you're prepared to help each other, you will find the way. Now, the way is through the Labour Party. The opportunities are there for you to become candidates, to move on to become councillors. And that way, you can help your people. Okay, we will always continue to help the communities of whatever culture, religion, whatever. But we want you, okay? So there's also that opportunity. But I could keep talking and talking, but I'm going to call it a day there. But, you know, please listen to what I've said. And if you do want to take advantage of anything that I've put on offer today, please see Samatar initially, okay? And congratulations to the Hounslow Somali community.
Waxaan jeclaan markaana inay Councillor C. Samson ay gudoon siiso abaalmarinta agaasimaha guud ee TV-ga caalamiga Universal Abdullahi Hirsey. Saabku waa xaqiina.
Aad baan u faraxsanahay dareenkayga soo ma koobi karo intan oo Soomaaliya inaan hortooda abaalmarin ugu qaado TV-ga aan ka mid ahay mas-uuliyiinta Universal TV oo ku aad u adeega ummadda Soomaaliyeed kuna hadla luqadda Soomaaliga. Hounslow Somali Community waxaa lagu amaani karaa oo aan rabaa inaan uga mahadceliyo leafleetyada la qori jiray English unbaa lagu qori jiray, laakiin kan waxaa ku qoran caawa Soomaali iyo English, taasoo caddaynaysa inaan nahay Somali British ama British Somali. Waxqabadkooda wax la soo koobi kara ma aha, maadaama ay promote gareeyeen jaaliyadii Soomaaliyeed ee Hounslow ku nooleyd. Shaqooyin badan ay u yaalaan Samatar iyo tiimkiisa. Waxaan leeyahay congratulations. Aad baan idinkugu mahadcelinaa si Universal TV on behalf of ku hadlaya tiimka Universal TV meel kasta ay joogaan. Ta xigta, waxaan rabaa caawa inaan kaga taga fariin walaalka iyo tiimkiisa. Mahadcelinta waxaan ka hilmaamay soo raalli ahaada dhalinyadii ruwaayadii dhaqan iyo dhoof dhigtay oo aad u qiimo badnayd oo aan leeyahay idinkuna waa mahadsantihiin. Waxaan rabaa wiilkan walaalkay Samatar iyo tiimka la shaqeeyay inaan aad ugu mahadceliyo fariin aan caawa kaga tago. Waxaan rabaa campaign inaad u gashid kulukamka waxbarashada Britain in Soomaali lagu daro. Scandinavianku Soomaali ayaa ku jira. Ilmaha Soomaaliyeed ee jooga Scandinavianka waxay bartaan luqadda Soomaaliga. Maxay faa'iido u tahay? Waxaan ka imid Soomaaliya. Wiilku markuu dalkan ka tago English uu yaqaana, reerkii ma fahmo, ayeeye ma fahmo, awowe ma fahmo. Aqoontiisu waa muhiim, laakiin dalkii waxba kama qaban karo, saa Soomaaliga ma yaqaana. Maxay noo taraysaa marka? Waxaan rabaa wiilkii iyo gabadhuba inay intana ka shaqeeyaan Soomaaliyana ka shaqeeyaan haddii loo baahdo. Waa waxa dalka kan uu noo soo dhaweeyey, citizenkan noo siiyey, deegaankan noo siiyey, nonsool inaan ku noolaane, inaan wax ka faa'iidno, waxna u soo celinno, dadkeen inaan wax ula noqonno. Marka campaign-kaas waxaan rabaa inaad ku daratid way yar tahay jaaliyadda Soomaaliyeed ama community-da ka jira Soomaali UK inay intan isu keenaan. Intan waxaa isugu keentay dadaalkaagii. Waxaan ognahay in lagu ofargareeyo dhaqaale inaad diida. Lama heli karo qof Soomaaliya ee community sameeyey ee lacag inta loo ofargareeyo maya yiraan. Kalsoonidaas waxaa ku siiyey hooyooyinkii dhalinyarada Soomaaliyeed ee kula degan Hounslow. Waxayna kugu siiyeen waxqabadkaaga iyo daacadnimadaada. Waa mahadsantihiin mar labaad iyo mar xiga.
Abaalmarintan waxaa la siinayaa barnaamijka arrimaha bulshada ka mid ah barnaamijyadii ugu wanaagsanaa uguna wanaagsan aan filayna inuu ugu wanaagsanaan doono ee ka baxa TV-ga Universal. Waa wariye Cabdixaafid Maxamuud Jaamac. Fadlan sacabkuna waa xaqiiq.
وانا إذن سلام إيجوي جينبا and وحن لسه عدي عبد الله هي تيم كاس ما أنا رجيني أرنتان on behalf of محل هانزلو أدب إنكم هذا علنيا كونسولر ردينا amazing كاو إذن لدة داري أيرام هذا علنينا and حقيقة والله حق بدن يهاي إن أول ليسيو لكن مرك قاركود and encouragement تبي يكون قن يسعي دي رجلين إن ال community عاجو شقيسيد and si hagar laana ayadoo aan mar walba aadan saxsanaan kirin oo khaldamaysid khalasku inta badan oo iga iimaan kara daawado ka iimaan kara laakiin bottom line ku waxa uu yahay in aan gacanta is qabsano united voice gacanta isku qabsano one community aanahay regardless of our political differences to be united and the only way aan wax ku qabsan karno halkan Soomaali baan ka nahay halkan Soomaali baan looga yaqaan Soomaali baan nahay inaan insaano loo nahay inta ka dib waxaan rabaa inaan u mahadceliyo Hanslo community and Somali community waxaan ogaa markii la aasaasay aniga laftigay guriga Hanslo uu ka tirsan yahay laakiin inaan ciilin baan u badanahay ayadoo waxba aysan jirinin ayuu dalmar ka soo shaqeeyay samatar ka soo shaqeeyay dabadeedna idinka garab istaagay hadiina idinku garab istaagay lahayd waa meesha Cabdullaahi Hirsi ka sheegay halkaan caawil ma soo gaarin lahayn police aan support gareyno Now waxaan rabaa wax yar oo election ka 2015 ka ku saabsan 7 of May. Waxa daruuri ah haddii Soomaalina hay we must vote regardless of cidda u vote gareysid laakiin we have to vote and our voices must be heard. Hadii kale waxaan noqonaynaa community yara oo lagu xisaabtamin oo magac lahayn oo feasible aanayn. Often politicians ka waxaan ka maqlaa inay yiraahdaan Somali community are not feasible. We need to change that. We are feasible and we're here to stay and we're not going anywhere anytime soon. So let's inshallah ta'ala. The only way that we can change the world is through the voting system. And that is the only way. Let's vote regardless of who we're going to vote. It's important that we vote. And having said that, I just want to conclude this. Grateful for the award and I'm grateful to stand here in front of you. I don't deserve, I know that, but thank you very much.
Waxaad la soo dhaweeyseen laba qof oo dhalinyaro ah oo run ahaantii dadaalay. Waliba wax barashada meel sare ka gaaray qarkood warbaahinta caalamka tan Soomaalida iyo tan caalamka intaba la uga hadlay waa Sulayqa Hussein iyo Fatima Yusuf.
We are here today to introduce an exciting opportunity through the Urban Youth Network, under which there is an organisation named Children of Diaspora that offers mentoring to Somali boys and girls individually. Currently we are running Daughters of Diaspora, a mentoring programme for Somali girls aged 14 to 20. Inshallah, in the near future, we'll begin the mentoring programme for boys aged 14 to 20.
Before we begin, let us ask you a quick question. What do Einstein, Oprah Winfrey, Bill Clinton, Nelson Mandela, Martin Luther King, and Malcolm X all have in common?
They all had a mentor to help guide them, which allowed them to progress to where they aspired to be. Now, you're probably wondering what a mentor is.
A mentor is someone who you look up to as a role model, who is there to inspire you and help you progress and achieve what you are capable of.
Okay, so why did we create the mentoring program? As you all know, Somalia has gone through a 24-year civil war, and the Somali youth are the ones that suffered the most and continue to suffer.
This quote really stuck out to me since it really highlights the issue. I'll read it out. For years, many Somalis kept their suitcases packed, ready to return to Africa for good, firm in the belief that they would soon be on the move. There was little point in putting down deep roots or encouraging their children to do so. Meanwhile, the current generation of Somalis were growing up in Britain.
This demonstrates the sad reality of our community because the Somali youth never stood a chance. Since they were torn from their homelands and then felt stuck between two worlds where they could not fit anywhere. Essentially, they have never had a place to truly call home. When they go to Somalia, they're considered very Europe, and when they're here, they're not considered fully British or fully European. Some of our issues our mentoring program will be focusing on is identity and the discovering of oneself through discussion in workshops and focus groups.
The Somali community is the largest minority group in the UK. However, we are among the lowest in achievement, whether it is through education, employment, and helping our community in comparison with other communities, such as the Bangladeshi, Pakistani, Jamaicans, and Nigeria, just to name a few. In 2009, a report by the Department of Communities and Local Government found that levels of education within our community are as low as 50% having no qualifications and only 3% having higher education qualifications. A recent survey in 2010 showed that roughly of those identified as Somali, only 75 people are in university studying an undergraduate or postgraduate degree. This is shocking and heartbreaking to see.
Okay, this is very important because recent statistics show that out of 1,370 Somalis in the UK right now, 80% are unemployed. That Somali-born UK people, not foreign-born Somalis, 80% of them are unemployed, 34% are in care, 62% are in jail or in gangs and at risk of criminality, and only 33% have finished with good GCSEs that are above a D. This means that our more Somali youths in care, prison and in gangs than in education or employment. In fact, this means that there's more people that you know of than of Somali people excelling in education or employment. Is this the future we want for our children? Is this the future we want for ourselves? Over the years, the number has slowly increased, but it's nowhere near where it should be and what we are capable of, especially in comparison to other ethnic minority groups such as Jamaicans, Pakistani, Indian, Moroccan and Nigerians, just to name a few.
Do you all remember the first group of people we talked about? We all had mentors. Now we're going to ask you another question. Can you name any Somali role models?
So most of you are thinking about Mo Farah, Iman, K9, Chef Roble, Abdi, Bille, and such. However, name ones that you can speak to on a weekly basis. As I can see from the look of your faces, this proves to be more difficult.
What if I told you you could speak to us on a weekly basis? I'm sure you're thinking, who are we and the other mentors? We are highly ambitious people and are currently studying at top university, where we graduated with top distinction.
So Daughters of Diaspora is a newly created mentoring program that targeted towards girls aged 14 to 20. The program is there to support, nurture, and develop personal growth through strengthening their identity, self-esteem, cultural awareness, and constructive self. We are a structured, holistic mentoring program that is based on theoretical frameworks drawing on theories on identity, the self, culture, and Islamic feminism.
Therefore, ensuring that our mentees gain more out of the program as they delve deeper into any issue. Since we are a non-profit organization, which is not government funded, we ask that you pay a small membership fee of £5 a month to cover the cost of activities, printing, books, and stationery equipment.
So firstly, let me ask you what you want to be. What are your highest goals and ambitions? It might be being a doctor, a midwife, an engineer, a lawyer, or others.
Do you know the steps to take to get there? As part of our mentoring program, we'll be able to facilitate sessions with students who are studying at top universities, which are studying your chosen degree, and professionals who are currently working within your field of interest.
We feel as though this is a stepping stone into improving and bettering our community, especially in a society where it's easy to fall off the right tracks.
Everyone needs a mentor, someone that they admire and look up to as role models. The mentors on our program will be those role models, helping and providing guidance to our mentees.
So what will be provided? In addition to one-to-one mentoring, we also have incorporated workshops and group discussion, as well as the Big Sister Little Sister program.
We feel as though this is important, as it gives responsibilities to the 16 to 20-year-old. Also, we would have career and educational tools, and all in all, we aim to provide a positive support system to Somali girls.
If you weren't convinced already, the benefits of joining the program would include
guaranteed safe and confidential area to discuss important issues relevant to yourself and make your voice heard,
brilliant help with any worries regarding education, employment and the future,
workshops to improve self-confidence and self-esteem,
to raise cultural awareness and gain a stronger identity as a result of it,
finally make friends and take part in activities such as play, dance, art, poetry and fashion.
The mentoring program will be held in Hangzhou, not far from here. The address is 1 Norwood Road, or come see us for a flyer if you're interested or if you have any questions.
Also, we will be having an induction session on Sunday, 1st of February at 4:30 or 6:30, where you will be given further information and and a taste today, and also we can answer your questions and concerns that you may have regarding the program.
We invite you all to come to it and ask any questions or concerns you may have. Thank you for listening, and we hope to see you soon.
Way hey, why not bilabanaya? Kaipti dan tada.
So.
waxaan u yeereynaa waa xagga gabayga iyo buraanburka ama fankii suugaanta, khaasatan suugaanta oo Soomaalidu ay ku caan tahay. Waxaan jeclahay markaan inaan u yeero Aisha oo diyaar inoogu ah inay qaado buraanbur.
Assalaamu calaykum waraxmatullaahi wabarakaatu. Dhammaan waan idin salaamay dadka halka sharafta la iskuga imaaday. Waxaan idin tirinayaa tix yar aan u diyaariyay Hanslow Somali Community. Hanslow Somali Community waa hooy Soomaaliya oo hirgelintiisu hay tahay. Hooyana aan ku oran waad soo habsaanto. Heedhow hool lagu qaban maayo. Hanslow Somali Community waa mid habsan isku soo dhiso, heer wacan gaadhaye. Hooyo af lagu ciiliyo, misana guri lagu canaadaaye, iyadoo xaq labaatan xaqa soo dhacan karine, balse heedhaha moogaan hoygani inuu yahay Hanslow Somali Community. Waa ciiltirihii carada kaa bixin lahaaye, waa Hanslow Somali Community.
Okay, way mahadsan tahay Aisha gabayga gaaban ama tixda ay ugu talagashay Hanslow Somali Community. Aisha, mar labaad fadlan saaxiibkiina, mahadsanid Aisha.
I'm not afraid. Sarvai 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 وليوم ويحق 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 ولي